Here I will show you how to place a text or 3D text in a curve wall. Let's make sure first that you select the floor plans or the floor level that you would like to place your wall. Here we go to architecture, select wall architecture, select basic wall generic 200 mm. Here we can set the height of the wall, which is around 4 meters. Click apply. Let's select and use the start end radius arc command. So let's create a half circle. Let's just maintain it at 15 meters, the length of the wall, or the diameter of the wall. Click here. Now let's go to the south elevation. Just click this section or section elevation views. So we can go to the south elevation. Let's create a plane where we need to place it at the center of this wall, the height of the wall. So here we can place the dimension. Now we can also adjust the dimension. The height of the wall we need to adjust. Select this. Select the reference plane. Let's set it at 2 meters height. Now you see it's adjusted to 2 meters height. So the text will be right about this. The top of the text will be at this reference plane. So now let's go to mechanical plan. Set the reference plane. Okay, we forgot to name that plane, so let's go back and then set this. Set the name of the plane as detail length. Then let's go to the floor plan, level 1. Let's set the reference plane. Set to detail line. Click OK. Let's place in some detail lines. Select annotate. Select detail line. And select this line. So let's place the line at the center of the wall. So let's place it at the external part of the wall. So now let's arrange this wall. This line, so we can create an array. Use the polar or radial. Select the number 8. We need to add in 8 numbers, and you see the placement of the center of rotation. We have to select it. Place center. Select the end line or center of the wall. Let's set the angle as 90 degrees. Click enter. Now you have set and place 8 numbers of detail lines for reference to place in the text. So now we go back to the 8 reference plane, select the endpoint, and we're going to do a perpendicular line from this angle. So let's say type in SP to make sure it's perpendicular. Let's use the reference plane and type in SP. So it's perpendicular. Let's name this as A. Now let's create another reference plane from this line, SP. Key in SP, so it will be. Key in SP, so it's perpendicular. Don't select the enter, just type in SP and it will automatically select the endpoint of the plane. So here we're going to use another reference plane, SP, click enter. Right click, cancel, reference plane, SP, so it will be perpendicular. Click, right click, cancel, reference plane, SP, select, right click, cancel, reference plane, SP, right click, exit of the command, reference plane, so it will be continuous, type in SP, select, right click, reference plane, SP, so it will be perpendicular, make sure it's perpendicular. And then cancel, so we exit out of the command. Now we're going to name all this reference plane based on the letter. So this is already A. Let's name this as U. capital U. We're going to spell Autodesk, so let's use it as T. Let's say this O. D. Sorry, D. E. This one, let's place it as E. This one, let's set it as S. Let's, this one is K. So now we're going to type in the letter Autodesk in this, or place the name the word Autodesk in this curve here. So now let's go back to the escape twice to the south part. Now we'll place in the model text. So let's go to architectural, place the model text. Now it will ask you to select a current workflow. So let's select A. Click OK. Type in the letter A. Select it to this wall. So let's type in again model text. Select a plane. Select U. Click OK. Let's type in, let's key in U. Somewhere here. So again, model text, select T, click OK, type in T. So now model text again, let's reference plane O, click OK, type key in O, or type in O, place it somewhere here. We will arrange it later. So now let's go to model text. Click in D, reference plane D, type in D, okay. So it's better if you name your reference plane with the same letter you're going to use or you're going to key in. So it's much better, much more easy for reference. So we're going for E, okay, click E. Then we're going to go model text, S. Click OK, type in S. Now we're going to go for the last letter, which is the letter K. Click OK, type in K. So now we have placed in all our letters following the reference plane, so it will follow the curvature of the wall. So now let's go to the 3D view and select or the plan view. So now that we have completed placing all the text, if you go to 3D, you can see it. But unfortunately, if you go to floor plans, we have this issue. But this can easily be resolved. We just go to the underlay, the floor plan mechanical one. Let's change the range base to level 1. So you can see level 1, click apply. As you can see, the letter will be shown. So now we can select each letter. Move that letter from the center to the endpoint of the line. So here we're going to move this. Let's select the middle endpoint of the reference line. Select this. Move. Select here. So move. Now we're going to jump to the end first because we are lacking of space here. It will overlap. So let's move this. Center, end of the line, move. These are the letters that we have created. So let's move center or midpoint to the end line. Here, move center to the end of the line. Now, if we go to 3D, select the 3D view, you can see that the Autodesk word has been created in the we haven't set the mechanical plans to templates, so let's set first. We cannot change the let's set it as mechanical plan, and then let's edit the view selection. So we cannot actually, if this is checked, we cannot change the settings of the drawing. So this is part of the visibility graphics. Anyway, we are here and we have encountered this issue. Just uncheck everything, apply, okay. Here you can select shaded. or plastic wireframe. Another thing is make sure that we are in a coordination or architectural view, so we can have these lines and walls as solid. So now we have it. You can also change each of these letters material and color, assign them some color and materials if you like. Here the depth you can also change to 250 to make it deeper. Material you can change to, let's say, let's select a proper material. Select this. Change here, appearance. In the graphics, make sure you check use renders appearance. Hit apply and then click OK. And select from different outside the wall. You can see that the copper, color, and material has been added into the 3D text. So that is how to place text in a curved wall. Thank you.